fidelity of this people. And also I would love to mention the fact that you can have a chance to give me a name in my country, because if you go to exchange your kilos, you'll get $100, you'll get probably $1 million. So you'll be having a chance to fill yourself with your name. And the last reason is if you are interested in history, if you heard about KGB, you still have it. It's the only one country in the world that still have KGB. So if you're interested in being in the heart of Europe, interested in being a millionaire, with four things, you have to go to that country.
So the KGB sounds exciting, but do we like the KGB?
I don't know.
Okay, great presentation, great content. Your
movement. I'm worried though.
You what?
I'm worried a lot.
Worried?
Yes.
Oh, you were nervous?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I was nervous.
Okay, there was a little bit of pacing with your feet.
Yes, side to side.
So I would want you in good, stable, zip-zap, zoom position. Also your hands, like look at where they are right now. Like they just kind of stayed there the whole time.
Yeah, like don't let me go.
Yeah, exactly. Like you're holding on to something. If you let go, you're gonna forget your presentation.
Yeah.
Now it's understandable to be a little nervous. It came off well though. You can do the eye contact thing where you just pretend that you're confident and you'll look confident. You could just believe us when we tell you that was a good presentation.
Okay.
We were engaged.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You bet.
Thank
you.
Thank you, guys.
All right. It's up to you. How did that feel? Were you nervous out there?
Yes, I was.
Okay. It's more intimate. It's more scary that way. I want to see you smile. All right? Yeah.
I'm nervous. It's hard to smile.
Well, think of the AB eye contact exercise we did. When you acted confident, you look confident. So if you look confident and you look friendly and happy, we'll take it that way. And there's also this saying is believing effect. So if you act like you're confident and act like you're happy, you will probably feel a little bit more confident and feel a little bit more happy. But I don't want to dwell on that because it was solid. Even though you appeared a little bit nervous and you appeared very serious, you were able to stick with those clear, succinct points. And that helped your presentation, helped your speech. All right, so that was interesting. I wrote down that there's a little bit of nervous gesture, which is kind of hard to explain because your hands were so stable. Everyone noticed that, like, his hands were like stable here, but he was kind of like doing a little twiddling, nervous with his thumbs. So what I would recommend is we take that nervous energy that's happening with your thumbs and make specific movements with your hands. So I'm an operations manager, I want to be an operations manager, and here's the important thing that I want to give you with that. And then put your hands back to resting position. So instead of nervous movements the whole time, three or four powerful movements like you're throwing a ball or doing a sit-zap too. Does that make sense? Yeah? Good job. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Daniel Kiemer, and I'm here to talk to you today about balance bikes. Now, when a parent goes out to buy the first bike for their child, what they really want is a bike that's going to allow their children to learn how to ride a bike properly. They also want it to be fun, and they also want their child to remain safe while they're learning to ride a bike. So, I personally believe, and I know that balance bikes are the best first bike for a child because they provide three things for the child as they're learning. First one is proper learning. They're going to learn how to ride a bike in the proper way, right from the get-go. Second one is natural fun. It's going to be fun for them in a natural way. And third is it's going to be safe for them, and it's going to be simple. So the first point was proper learning. So I'm going to do a comparison between traditional training wheels, which a lot of people use when they're learning how to ride a bike, versus a balance bike. So for the training wheels, the child is forced to learn how to pedal first instead of with a balance bike where they learn to balance first. It's a natural thing. With a balance bike, the child can gain confidence in themselves as they slowly learn and they progress. And then when it's time to get on a real bike, they already have that confidence. I know how to balance. All I need to do is learn how to pedal. Move the bike in a different way. The second one is it's natural fun. With a traditional training wheels, it's a little uncomfortable. It might feel a little unnatural for the child at first, and the parents will oftentimes force that on the child, which makes the learning process kind of scary and really not fun at all for the child. A lot of people have scary traumatic experiences learning how to ride a bike. A balance bike, on the other hand, is very natural. Children naturally walk and run, and so that's what they do on a balance bike. They get on and that's how they live their life, is walking and running. It's natural. They feel comfortable. It also allows the children to start at a younger age. As soon as they can walk pretty much, they can start on a balance bike. And then the child can also learn at their own pace. Instead of being forced, they feel like it's fun, and they're in control of the learning process. Third point was simple safety. So with the training wheels, there's extra parts on the bike that create extra weight, stick out the side of the bike and cause potential injury. With a balance bike, those things aren't there. It makes the bike lighter, it makes it easier to control, and also those extra parts aren't there, so it makes it safer for the child to ride. So as you can see from the comparison that I just did, a balance bike is obviously the best option for a child as they're learning to ride, and it provides those three important things that a parent wants for a child as they're learning. And those three things, again, are proper learning, natural, fun, and simple safety. Thanks.
Good job. Great tone of voice, great eye contact, great connection with the audience. Great use of notes, too. I think of all the presentations of all the people who used notes, you used them the most effectively. Because we didn't lose anything because you were reading or because you were using notes. We still felt like we were getting it. Would you agree with that? Like, you were still relating to us very, very effectively, and you were using that as a guide. A little bit of pacing back and forth with the feet. Watch that, and I'll turn the camera so you all can see this if you like. It wasn't a huge detriment to your speech, but I would just rather have you in zip-zap zoom position, stable body, so that we can focus on you and your words and your great tone of voice. Got a little long. We forgave you because you were connecting with us, but you could have tightened it up a little bit. We got, especially because you're 3 points, I think there was one earlier. Who was it? Oh, it was Rashish. his went on for real. I forget who, whoever said. One was long, but the comment I gave that person was, we got your points early on, so it didn't need to be that long, so it felt longer than it was. So because you were so clear and effective with what your points were going to be, when it went on, we're like, we got it, we got it. Make sense?
Yeah, I was trying not to lean on with them too much as I did in practice.
Okay, so. That's understandable. So maybe as a result of you talking more to us, we felt more of a connection, which is good. But it also went a little bit long, which is something you can think about that being. Okay. Yes. Oh.
What do? What do I buy? And I have two reasons why to tell you that the best thing you can do for yourself is just go on a trip. The farther, the better. Reason number one, when you go on a trip, you always take something with you. It's not gonna break, it's not gonna run out or just wear out. It teaches you about other cultures, and at the same time, it refreshes you. It's always good to take a break. So I'll go into more detail. So the reason why I'm saying that it doesn't break, you know, do you know anyone who buys a cell phone and is walking out of the store and suddenly they completely break? They have to buy a brand new one. If no one is going to take that away from you, these are not material things that are going to be out of style. It's something that you take with you. You know, it's your experience, something you have played. And you have pictures with it. It makes it grow. Now, it teaches you about other cultures also. It teaches you to be more tolerant, to accept other people and understand, oh, you know, yes, when I visited that country, you know, I understood that this is what they do this instead of doing what I've always known what to do when it's a birthday, a wedding, you know, any particular celebration, the food people eat, you know, it's very interesting when you learn about someone else's traditions. And the third reason is that it always refreshes you. You know, it's always good to take a break, especially if it's winter time, right? It's always nice to go away and have a different weather, go to the beach, but then listen to different music. It's so enriching. You know, you learn so much and you take that with you. Like I said before, it's not gonna break, it's not gonna run away. It's something that makes you grow as a person. So that's the reason why I always suggest and I encourage you to take a week or two of vacation and go on a very nice trip. Like I said, the farther, the better. Thank you.
Good job. Great connection. Mm-hmm. Great icon. Did you feel nervous? Did you feel like you didn't do a good job up there?
Because I was nervous, yeah, a lot.
Did anyone notice that she was nervous?
No. It was very personal.
I would not have guessed that you were nervous at all. Good stable stance. Good eye contact. Good hand gestures. And you were excited about this. So it drew us in because of that content was important to you. And also you organized the content in a way that was clear. This and this. I want to go on that trip.
I'm personally impressed because I know she didn't have that prepared when she walked into work, so she needed to practice
that. Oh, you just made it up.
So. Yeah, I just, you know, it's
fantastic.
So
perfect.
I just read the headline and then I just selected the board.
Awesome. Great.
She didn't even know what the assignment was. I told her when she walked in today.
Okay. Great. I'll get you a syllabus. Great to have you in class.
Thank you.
You? Okay. Fantastic.
Imagine a situation and you stay at home watching TV
Do you want to start again? Just start again? Or shake it up?
Oh, yeah.
Just start again.
Imagine a situation. You stay at home, watch a movie. with a total amount of $30,000. Colleagues went into the investigation. They found that the reason was that his Visa card got duplicated by an email. So here comes the personal private information safety issues. While the information security is becoming more and more worse, how do I protect my personal information safety? Here, I want to give you some advice. How many of you have ever remember that when you go on shopping, please make sure you don't connect to the public Wi-Fi, because in this way, because the hacker will, because it's not a hard job for hackers to record your bank information. And please don't enter into the station website. So you should watch very carefully. You should watch very carefully about the domain's name. The second advice I will give you, when you go to withdraw cash in the ATM machine, but don't go to the ATM machine in the remote locations. You should make sure there is cameras or electronic eyes on that machine to make sure your safety. The third question I want to give is to after you have done a transaction, you will often get a receipt. Please make sure you take good care of your receipt, because a hacker can easily duplicate your information with information on receipt. The last suggestion I want to share is to use a complex password. Don't use your birth date, don't use your ID card number, and please always keep your ID card and your Visa card separate. Have a safe journey along the way from using your Visa card. Thank you.
Oh, good job.
I just think, I came from China, my English is so poor.
I thought that was pretty well spoken. Would you all agree? I've seen much, much worse. I could understand all your words clearly. I could understand your points. Yes.
At the beginning, I could tell how at the beginning you were very nervous, and then at the end you were getting unclear and calm.
tell that they do feel better about it.
Yeah, even in this eye contact, she was staring at you first, and after like a couple of minutes, she started looking at us.
Yeah, so good eye contact, good spread, your hands were open. You could have used them a little bit more, but at least you weren't making any nervous gestures, and you were open the whole time. You could have used them like to create a zip-zap zoom type of thing, so a hacker can get your information and you're in trouble. Then back to resting position. So what I recommend are complex passwords. Back to resting position. I'm just thinking of points where you could use your hand gestures. So yeah, good eye contact, good open language, or good open body language. Again, I could understand all your words. I could hear you clearly. I think English is, you speak English very well. Absolutely. I think what would have helped your presentation the most is thinking about those clear outline, a clear outline or clear subheadings. You could have gone through your presentation faster. That's why it's helpful to have four clear subheadings or three clear subheadings and then just talk to us. So you know the three things that are important to credit card safety, and then talk about point one. Connect with us with good eye contact and just tell it. Don't worry about exactly the way you read it and wrote it on your paper. That's not important. What's more important is you connect with us clearly. I would not describe your posture as nervous. There were no nervous gestures. You might be a little stiff because you were like this. You were like this the whole time, like somebody's hands up. I'll give you the money. But honestly, being like this is better than being like this. So at least you were open. The point I made is that there were parts of your speech when you could have engaged your hand gestures by saying, all right, if a hiker gets your, a hacker, you kept saying hiker, that's the one thing, like hiker instead of hacker. That's the one thing, so hacker. Because if a hacker gets your information, then you could be in trouble. You could have used something like that. And then gone back to a resting position here, and then maybe used a forward gesture here a couple of times. Had this be your resting position. And this is not a bad resting position either. That could work. Thank you.
Thank you for your time.
No, thank you. I'm sorry to keep you all here after class.
You
were
very helpful. I appreciate it.
All right. And welcome to the class. Do you need a syllabus?
It's actually available on our platform.
Yeah.
It wasn't in the morning. Emailed you, so you can just go on the
email. Okay, great. And I'll give you a syllabus, but you'll also want to access it online because there are a bunch of links in there.
But I don't have.
Right, here's class one. We have class two. Good. All right,
thank you again,
Pepper. Thank you. See you next week.
See you next week.
Oh, and Paula, do you have my information if you need to? Oh, yeah, you got it. It's on the syllabus, yeah.